In the scientific literature about erectile dysfunction, a trend has become visible. When I started my medical career, atherosclerosis dominated the scene. I mean, it makes sense that if circulation is blocked because of narrow arteries, less blood will be able to enter into the penis. And this holds true up until today. But with scientific progress, inflammation has become the focus of attention. My name is Stefan Buntrock and I'm a board-certified urologist and sexologist. Why should you care about inflammation? Because you are affected, and this applies to pretty much all of you who regularly watch UroChannel. Inflammation is part of the deal when you get older. It can't be avoided completely, but it's easy to make it worse, starting with the wrong food that's pro-inflammatory. I am planning a number of videos with recipes of anti-inflammatory food right now, so it could be a good idea to subscribe and activate all notifications for not to miss out when I upload them. Chronic inflammation is responsible for endothelial dysfunction. The endothelium in blood vessels has very important functions. Among others, nitric oxide is produced here. You may know that nitric oxide is a gas and may be the most important chemical component for erections. Without nitric oxide, there will be no erections. It's as simple as that. So basically, we want to avoid chronic inflammation at all costs because it threatens erectile function. As a doctor, I always look for easy diagnostic tools and lab hacks how to find out about whether my patient is inflamed. I mean, there is the CRP, the C-reactive protein, which is made by the liver. It can be measured by a simple blood test and increases as a response to inflammation. But it is not very specific, so trauma and infection will also make it rise. But recently, I found a promising biomarker of inflammation in the literature, the NLR, the neutrophil-to-lymphocyte ratio. Both belong to the white blood cells. Lymphocytes are part of the immune system and can be seen in chronic inflammation. Neutrophils are the ones first to be seen in acute inflammation, so with a simple blood test, the NLR can be calculated. You can do that too, with your own lab results from your doctor. It has been suggested that an NLR above 1.94 predicts whether you are in danger of developing erectile dysfunction. For me as a professional, it is a marker worth knowing because it enables me to counsel my patients on risk reduction, and with the NLR, we have a tool to monitor progress. It may come as a surprise to you that there is a drug capable of reducing general inflammation of the body. The name of the drug is tadalafil. You might know it by the name of Cialis. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.